Hey you guys, I hope you're having a great day. I wanted to do a little bit of rapture encouragement for you and look at some scripture. So I've been going through Revelation, doing a personal Bible study, and I wanted to share this with you guys. I want to share with you the 24 elders of Revelation. And Revelation 4:4 is where the 24 elders are first mentioned. And it seems to me like when I'm reading through scripture and I'm digesting this during my study, the 24 elders are actually the church. They represent the bride of Christ in heaven, seated on their throne during the tribulation period. In Revelation 4:1, we see that there is a possible reference to the rapture of the church because there was an open door in heaven. And in Revelation 4:4, right afterwards, we see 24 elders sitting on thrones, clothed in white and wearing golden crowns. So let's digest this a little bit. I'm going to use scripture to define scripture as it should be, okay? So some of these things I'm going to be paraphrasing, and some of it I have the verses written down so I can just share it with you guys. And I'm doing the best I can because I'm actually holding the camera, so bear with me. I have one free hand right now. Okay, so Revelation 4:4. There are 24 elders sitting on 24 thrones. We are told that we will reign with Christ, those who believe in Jesus. In Revelation 3:21, it says, "To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne, as I also overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne." So we are actually seated in the heavenlies with Christ now and whenever we are raptured and resurrected. And 1 John 5:5 defines who the overcomer is. Who is he who overcomes the world but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? That is, anyone who believes that Jesus died for their sin and rose again on the third day. They believe 1 Corinthians 15:1-4, and they have called upon the Lord and asked for the forgiveness of their sins. That is a believer. That is he who overcomes. That is who will be granted to sit with Jesus on his throne. Revelation 4:4 also says that these 24 elders will be clothed in white garments. And throughout scripture, white garments represents purity and righteousness. And not just any kind of righteousness, such as self-righteousness, which isn't righteousness at all. I'm talking about righteousness that comes only through belief in Jesus. Revelation 3:5 says, "The one who conquers will be clothed thus in white garments." Once again, that language, overcomer, conqueror, who is that? A believer. Revelation 7:13-14 also talks about the tribulation saints coming out of the tribulation period after they are martyred for their belief in Jesus, for their testimony in Jesus. They are also given white robes. So white garments, white robes represents righteousness that comes only through belief in Jesus. Revelation 4:4 also says that these elders have golden crowns on their heads. We know as believers, we receive crowns. There are different crowns that can be received. Revelation 2:10 talks about one of them. The crown of life is given to those who are faithful unto death. There are many other crowns, like I said, in many other places in scripture where they are, but I'm just going to read one more scripture to you guys for the sake of time. 1 Corinthians 9:24-25. "Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown." So what is being said here is that the believers will receive crowns, okay? I'm not gonna get too into detail with that. I'm just trying to share with you guys what I found and how I'm feeling about these 24 elders, which I believe are the church, seated with Jesus on his throne during the tribulation period. So in Revelation 4:10, it also says that the elders fell down and worshiped, which we know we are going to be worshiping Jesus as soon as we get to heaven, and they cast their crowns. therefore saying that their crown was not obtained by anything that they did, but only because it was given to them by Jesus. Because we are not righteous from our on our own, we have to have our faith in Jesus to actually get the righteousness that he gives to us freely. He gives that to us freely, and it's a gift. And Ephesians 2:8-9 says that it's not by works, lest anyone may boast. Okay, so I believe that these 24 elders are the church who are in heaven throughout the whole tribulation period. And we will be celebrating, you guys. So there are other views about the 24 elders. I did a little bit of research to see what other people think. And some people say it may be representing the actual Jewish nation, representing Israel. However, the purpose of the tribulation is for the salvation of the Jewish nation. Thank you, J.D. Farag. I love that statement, and I am using it, but I am giving the credit to you on that one. But it is so simple that it just doesn't make sense to me that there would be representation for Israel in heaven during the tribulation period if the Israelites haven't even come to that knowledge that Jesus is their Messiah, and they come to that knowledge during the tribulation period. So I don't think that's a good interpretation of this, that it's representation for Israel. So are the 24 elders maybe like literal people, like the 12 disciples, other apostles that walked with Jesus as well? I don't think so, but I mean, that's a possibility, and I can't say with 100% certainty that I know everything, because I'm learning and the Holy Spirit is revealing new things to me every single time I read through scripture. Not that any core foundation of my faith is changing, you guys, but you know what I'm talking about. If you do Bible studies, you know that the Holy Spirit, he will reveal things to you the more and more you study. It's awesome. It's like putting a puzzle together, and I love it because I like puzzles. I don't know about you guys, but I do. Okay, so that's basically it. I don't really have anything else for you guys. I do want to do. I don't know how you guys watch my videos sometimes. I'm like all over the place with my words. Anyways, hopefully you're laughing at me right now, or with me, laughing with me. But anyway, I want to do another rapture encouragement video for you guys about another little focus study I did in Revelation during my Bible study, but I will do that at a later time. And I hope to see you guys in the clouds so very soon. It is a great day to be raptured, you guys. God bless.